The tabloid boys wouldn't have been interested in this one. Fans and locals in World Cup good time kickabout. It doesn't sell newspapers, does it? But what went on afterwards, later that night, the comic brigade would have seen as something to really get their teeth into.
About half an hour ago, got back here via another campsite about half a mile up the road. And there was a lot of activity. And I saw tons and tons of troops who apparently had surrounded about 30 people at gunpoint. And people were completely freaked out. A very weird atmosphere. Came back here to find that a police bus had come here with carabinieri with guns. Come in through the gate, and everyone here who, well, people are fairly drunk here. The majority are fairly drunk. But what had happened was bottles were being thrown at the carabinieri. And they left. And things have sort of calmed down now, but it's just gone absolutely bonkers. But out of the people who got involved in that, I mean, it was just, you know, basically about five of these guys here. There's about sort of 30 still up. And, you know, about five of them, literally five or six people, are psychos there, and we're prepared. We were in a campsite in the middle of nowhere. There were five guys there who were prepared to take on paramilitary with guns. And they're completely mad. They're totally mad. But we've got a good bloke who's in charge of the campsite here, who has telephoned the carabinieri and calmed the situation down by, you know, telling them that it's the best thing to do is just, you know, not come anywhere near here, because these guys, even though there's, you know, just a few psychos who are prepared to go for it, there's other guys here who are really drunk and out of their heads, completely out of their heads, who would do something absolutely ridiculous. And if this carries on around here, there's just going to be big, big trouble. And it's madness.
Εκεί, αν τον είμαι ο Μάνκο, δεν ρωτώ πού έτρεχε όλα τα εννοεί.
Τα καζερολάκια.
Τι, τι, μπαίνει τα πέ. Και δεν σου σκάσαν τα. Τι καμίνα.
In my camp,
nothing happened. There was some trouble I heard in another campsite not far from here. And what happened was they were looking for a troublemaker. From the news I got, they caught the troublemaker, and it seems that carabinieri car was the windows were broken.
After the police had gone and that, because there was some trouble down the road, a few of the English lads a bit drunk and that singing. Basically, the police turned up in riot gear, rather overreacted, steamed in there with all their riot gear. And before that, as far as I could tell, before they had a chance to do anything, they was attacked by the English bottles and that. And the police legged it.
There's just no reason for it, like, because it was all sat over there, like, singing. And like, they all came charging, all with shields and that.
Did they?
Yeah, all came.
Anyone away?
No, like, but they was all stood, like, you know, just like on steps over there. And like, everyone was like, just going, you know, there's like, egging us on, like, really. And, like, somebody threw a bottle at them and that. And everyone started walking towards them and pushed them back, like. And we were like, all that like, quieting down. And they go on like, the bus. And as it was going, some a couple of windows that the bus got put through.
There was someone selling strange cigarettes. Let's call them strange cigarettes. Yes. I don't know what you call them.
Smoking dope.
Yeah, smoking dope. Yeah. All right, but
yeah.
I don't know if it's true or not. But this is what I heard. So the carabinieri, I'll say efficiently, you know, got hold immediately of the two lads that they were trying to raise trouble.
Like, I don't know, some lads like were tripping and that, and
They were what?
Some lads was tripping, like, you know. Yeah. And I said, no, like...
What, acid?
Yeah. Like, they were just all that... Just, it just got blown out of proportion, really. And everyone was, like, shouting and that. So, there was nothing, there was no trouble.
Gina's a bit upset.
Yeah, because, like, everyone was shouting and... Somebody, like, told him, F off, like, he reckons. But I don't think anybody did. None of the lads who's been here all the time would have done that anyway. Because
right.
he's been OK with us, like, you know.
I had me flag on me tent here, and I was that ashamed of what was happening.
You
were what? I was that ashamed of what was happening. I took me flag down, I was ashamed to call myself English.
I couldn't believe what was going on. A number of fans had already left, fed up with what was happening in the campsite at night. With armed guards outside the gate, it was getting dangerous. No one involved in football, Italia 90 or the FA, had been near the campsite. Gino had all the problems.
I mean, it should have been my duty. I have to say, it should be my duty to make everybody respect the regulations of this campsite. And from now onwards, that is what will be done. At midnight, everybody has to be in bed asleep. Otherwise, I personally have to call the carabinieri and get this campsite cleared.